Finally, the week is over. Time to play some of my new games with my friends. You guys are gonna love it. I put my heart and soul into this masterpiece, and we can even play together. Everyone, grab controller and let's start playing. Hello? Hello? Alright, robot, I'll let you play some games. But if you want to be any good at it, you're going to need some upgrades. Let's go over the plan of action one more time. The first step is fixing the base rotation. Moving around a bunch of weights is no easy task. And right now, the stepper motor is directly driving the axis, giving it only a 200 step resolution per rotation. By giving it some gearing, we can solve both problems at once. Just like how changing the gears on your bike makes it easier to pedal, but you have to pedal a lot more to cover the same distance. Planetary gears like these ones are a great way to reduce the gearing, and they're pretty compact too, resulting in a 3x reduction. That should be much easier on the motor. Next up is fixing the weak servos. These measly 65kg servos are way too weak for the new robot, so let's just get one that's twice as strong. Of course, to make the change, I'll need to redesign basically everything, from the base all the way to the end, making each part just a little bit bigger to fit the new beefy hardware. And to finish things off, we need to show the robot is totally different from the previous model by giving it a whole new color. Alright, you got all that? Let's start building the arm. Wait, what's this? Oh, look at that! It's already done! A working Robotarm 2.0, what a wonder. Well, I hope the redesign improves its gaming potential. Let's test it out with some exciting motion control gaming. And we're off. Robotarm is off to a great start, making very good turns. Look at this movement. All right, a good drift, and oh, that's a railing. And oh no, we can quickly recover, no problem. Making good turn, yes. Left turn, right turn. All right, already up, second place. Can he finish the job? With a good move, and yes! He won the race. Okay, so maybe he can't play games on his own yet, but hey, you had to learn how to ride a bike as well. Time to teach the robot some new tricks. Oh, what's this? Maker Faire, Kent? Oh, aha! This could be the perfect opportunity to show my robot arm. Having thousands of visitors compete against my robot arm is gonna be so much fun. But I can't just let him be mediocre at Mario Kart. He needs to be the best gamer there ever was. He needs to beat every visitor so bad they will never dare to question the new robot supremacy. They will trample on... Oh, sorry. I got a little carried away. I'm just going to make a fun game everyone can understand in 10 seconds. And has about 2 minutes of fun. But how is it going to work? Well, let me explain in 10 seconds. Everyone plays as a robot car in an arena. In the center, there are a lot of balls. You need to get as much balls as possible in your camp, even if it means stealing from the others. Alright, simple enough. So, I guess I'll need to make this game now, huh? Let's start with placing the racer in a giant arena and getting it moving. It's not going to catch any balls standing still, right? The racer is basically a ball with some extendy bits, so all I need to do to move it around is push the ball forwards in the direction the camera is facing. Then, the prongs need to follow that direction as well, making sure they always stay upright. And just like that, we have ourselves a moving racer. Now, where are my rivals? Let's add the other racers. Give them all a camera. And now, we have 4 players that can all play at the same time. But wait, how are they going to play? 4 hands on a keyboard might be a little tough, right? And on top of that, I want to use motion controls, so my little friend over there can join the fun. Last time I made a motion control game like this, I used an Arduino with an accelerometer, disguised as a shopping cart handle. But making one of those was a lot of work. And I don't have time to order more parts and make 3 more. The Maker Faire is in 3 days. You need to think, Jelle. What could you use? Something with built-in motion controls. Not now, Servo. I need to find a solution quickly. Poking me is not going to make me think faster. What is it? Oh, no. I'm not going through that hell again. Don't you remember last time I used Wiimotes? Connecting them was a living hell. No, I know there is nothing better around, but... Okay, fine. But, Oh no, I forgot how I did everything. How can I possibly write it all again? What a bummer. I guess I'll just have to find something else. Ugh, why do I have to put everything on GitHub? Give me that code.
2 seconds later.
Oh, it just broke. Maybe it wasn't such a bad idea after all. Good job, past me. I can't keep testing the game with all four controllers. I only have 2 hands after all. I'm going to need some AI. Let's start really simple. Racer C ball, Racer chooses ball, Racer go to ball. Go get them balls. Alright, now you need to get back to your goal. If player has ball, go back. No wait, turn first. Yes. Okay, yes. Good. Okay. Very nice and straight. Alright. Now, let go of the ball. Hey, I said let go. Hey, here you go. Yep. Hey. Alright, let's just make him go back a little bit. So now that the AI can play a proper game, let's put them against each other.
Yes, they're off. They're all racing to grab the balls. Who will be the first one to grab one? And it looks like blue is the first one, but the other 3 robots also have their balls. Green just grabbed the last one. The other guys are chasing him. Will he be able to defend his lead? We're witnessing a big power struggle, all fighting for the same balls. Is that who I think it is? Yes, it's Orange. Orange has a ball. But look at Green. 3 balls, all for himself. Oh no, never mind. Pink just stole one. Oh, and so did Blue. And Orange too. But Green is back. Yes, he grabbed one. Blue is on the hunt now. Green is desperately trying to get his ball in goal. Oh no, he loses it. Ah, and he saves it the last second.
The basic gameplay is complete. Time to add some actual goals and a way to see how good you're doing compared to the rest. Because I made it so you can play from 2 all the way to like 10 players, I created a prefab goal part that I can spawn around the arena and color it to the current player's color. And then I'll add these giant score displays so you can always see how the other players are doing. And yourself, of course. Let's finish things off with a start and end screen, and the game is done. Enough. Alright, it's time. Servo, grab a controller. Oh, that's right, you don't know what to do yet. Lucky for you, I designed you to be perfect for controlling motion control games. The first thing to do is import my robot controller into the game. I already split the input from the racers, so instead of letting the CPU directly control the racers, I convert the left and right movement to the wrist roll, and the forwards and backwards movement to the wrist pitch. Now, all that's left to do is sending the commands to the robot arm. Sending the commands to the robot arm. To the robot arm. What's wrong now? What do you mean I can't connect to the robot arm server? It worked fine when I was connected to the internet. Stupid Wi-Fi cards. Alright, if I just bypass the firewall and overwrite the mainframe using the metaverse as a 10 gigs switch, calibrating the digital output to return an input connected by overstimulating the openness. Have you tried turning it off and on again? As I said, sending the commands to the robot arm. Yes, gamer, let's go. Take those balls. But not too fast. I still want to beat you. Alright, everything works and I still have like 3 hours left until the Maker Faire starts. I started way too soon. Let's pack up and go. I had a lot of fun showing off the game at the Maker Faire, and I think the people did too. Events like this are why I love making these projects. To see people enjoy the things I create is the best feeling in the world. Be sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Maybe even for real. Bye!